hands on the trigger, all eyes on the gun. They don't believe that we're strong enough to hold on. 'Cause I'm the only one to get you, the only one to figure you out. You're a place that I can go to, a face I couldn't live without. And nobody sees what we do.
This is my guinea pig's outdoor hutch. He also has an indoor one, which, because it's still a bit cold outside, it's getting hotter, warmer, but it's still quite cold outside. So he actually lives indoor at night, and then during the day he'll come out and live in here. So I just wanted to give you a tour of all of this. So on the bedroom area, it says beware of the guinea pig, and there's a little sign there. But I'll just show you up here first. So this is a lid that actually lifts off, but I'm not going to lift off because it's in a sheddy bit for my rabbits as well, which they're not living in here yet because it's not completely finished, but I will give you a tour if it is finished. I might do a quick tour of it now as well. So he lives in this hut. I can't remember the measurements, but I will find it out for you. And maybe put it in the description. But yeah, so on top there's like a bucket and it's full of hay, but there's more in the garage. That's kind of just for spots. Behind there, there's a tunnel, which is also boxes, but I don't want to cluster up his run. And then that's a picture I drew in laminated. I actually copied it off the internet, but I drew it myself, so I don't want any like harsh comments saying, "Oh, I saw that on the internet," and everything like that. But so I will just show you this part, which is, you know, this part first. It's like the bedroom area. A lot of people call this part the kitchen area, so I will call it that as well. So I just got to turn around because it's like quite small in here. So yeah, so these are not very good locks, especially this one. This one's good, but this one isn't. It's a bit loose. So yeah. So basically, in here, there's like a massive pile of hay. He can stay in that and be warm and eat it. Underneath is sawdust and straw. And I haven't bothered with newspaper because I'll tell you in that bit, but there's the hole that goes in there. So it's small, but it's the perfect size for one guinea pig. So I wouldn't say maybe put two in, but I think one is like, if you have one guinea pig, it's the perfect size, and I only have one. So yeah. So I just turn around and go in this area. So firstly, on the door we have a little Christmas wooden chew, and we have his water bottle. So he has his munch bowl here, which has got a few pellets from last night, which I'll probably put back in there because I don't want any like rats or anything seeing it. So yeah, so the substrate, like it was in there, is sawdust and straw. And the sawdust is like really nice sawdust, it's not dusty or anything, and it's soft. So I thought that's great for bedding. Can't remember where it was because I just had to stop because my dad was coming into the driveway and I had to close the gates for him. But I think I was talking about substrate. So yeah, it's sawdust underneath for softness on his feet, and then there's straw on the top just for extra warmth. He does like it. It's really hard to see, but he does like it in the corner there. I guess it's because you can see it's flattened down. I guess it's because food's right ahead of him. So yeah. The ramp is here, and it just goes down there, but you can't see. And then there's this. So it's like a little love heart. And you do that, and so if you wanted him to stay down there or stay up here, Like, say I'm cleaning down here and I wanted him up there so I could clean down here, then I shut that. Or if I wanted him down there because I was cleaning that, and then I shut that. So yeah, but I leave it open because I'd want him to have lots of room. So yeah, that is it. It's a bit plain, but it's kind of just the warm area, sort of. So I want him to try and get down here because it's only been his second day out of here, and it's been a whole day today, but yesterday it wasn't. So yeah, he hasn't quite explored down here because there isn't any poo. So it has one of these locks, which aren't very good, to be fair. They're not very safe. And I know these holes are quite big, so a rat could fit through there, but it doesn't matter because we have this. These holes you can see are big, but there's no more mesh there, so the rats can't get in. You can see the cars there, but that doesn't matter because our cars are electric, so they won't suddenly scare the rabbits or anything, and it doesn't create much gas or anything like that. So don't worry, we would not have put them here if we didn't think it was safe. But I will give you a full on tour in a minute about there. So yeah, going in here, so it's a small door, but that's fine because he's a small guinea pig. So down here it's like slab, so it's quite cold, but in the summer I guess it would be nice. There's a stone there. So in the summer I guess it will be quite nice, which is fine. It'll keep him cool. But in winter, he probably won't come down here because it is quite cold. But if he does, I've given him a hay rack full of hay. There's these two chews. So there's a, I don't know, I think it's like a radish or something. It's not a tomato, I think it's a radish. And then there's like a banana. So yeah. And then he's got a stool here which he can go on or go underneath. And then there's the ramp. So he hasn't got much toys because, again, I think I might have said, or if I haven't, he doesn't chew many wooden things. And I just wanted that from Christmas because it's nice decoration, even if Christmas was ages ago. I don't care, it's a star and he's a star, so I'm just keeping it there. yeah, so I actually got this from Target. You can't really see it, I think it's a lazy bones. But I would never, there's a picture of a rabbit, but I would never put like a rabbit in here. It's not very big, and again, like I said, guinea pigs, I would only put one in here personally, but I think two would kind of be alright. But yeah, so over here is where I store kind of the food and stuff. So I'll just show you the guinea pig's food is the top drawer, because if I open these drawers, the rabbits are less likely to be able to get in and eat these. But if I open this, this is the rabbit's, it's the middle drawer. It probably can, but that doesn't matter because it's rabbit food and it's not like they'll be accessing it all the time. So yeah, the rabbit guinea pig food is in here. I've got this cup here for a scoop. And I'm just gonna put, it's kind of night time sort of, I think it's about 6:30 maybe. I'm just gonna put his, I don't know if you can see, I'm just gonna put his food bowl in there because, like I said, I don't want any rats smelling the food. So yeah, the rabbit food's in there, as you saw. Well, I will do like a proper thing. And then in here is like a load of toys and supplies. But yeah, I'll probably do like a proper organization thing. And this is just kind of the rest of the run, but I'll give you a proper tour when it's finished, and I might give you a quick one. So this is it from here. So the rabbits have got that running area, and they've also got two, they can probably jump up onto that pink organization thing and onto the hutch. Paving slabs down all the way again, and there's a few toys. So like, we're gonna take hutches here, like I showed you. So I've just got a few toys, not all of their toys, but so there's this little ball here, which I don't know whether I keep, I'm just, they won't chew it or anything, it's furry, but it's just a little jingly ball, so I think it's kind of cute. Then there's this like cat fish thing. And then there's a mineral stick, and there's also a bluey green one which Casper's got in his hutch at the moment. So there's the pink thing and there's the hutch, and then here is like a plastic flap, so it kind of stays warm in there. This plastic is quite good about that. But they can also go in and out at night, so it's kind of dark, but I'll show you from inside because I want them to be able to. The reason I've got a flap there and not blocking it off, I think if it's safe in the daytime, then I'm sure it's safe at night. And it's kind of tricky doing this. So I want them to be able to have as much room as they like. So I'm just gonna go back and try and show you it. So it's not focusing. There we go. So yeah, it's really cute. I think it's more like a playhouse sort of thing. So there's Chive. They cannot eat that, so I'm going to move that. I found out, because it's like part of the onion family, so please don't give to guinea pigs or rabbits. This is mint. They can. I know rabbits can. I haven't quite found out about guinea pigs yet. And rosemary, the same. Rabbits can. Haven't found out about guinea pigs yet, but I will. So that's just in front, and then there's these big pebbles down, and then there's like this small hideous stones. So I've just got a brick here that props the door open. So here's the window. You can't really see in, it's dark. And here's my beware of the rabbit sign. Here's the little lock thing. It's really secure, don't worry. It's like really tight. So again, the lino hasn't been put down. So let me just put this brick up, hang on. The lino hasn't been put down. The lino hasn't been put up, so put down, so they can't live in here yet. But okay, so I have this picture here that I drew, found off the internet again, but I did draw it. So the flap is here. I have this thing here, which isn't very protected. It's just so they, when they don't run out as soon as I open it. The good thing about this door is it does shut straight away. That door doesn't stay open, so I'm gonna get a lock from the inside, and I'll probably do the same for here anyway. So yeah, there's just the normal shed flooring. There's a food mat and like a water bowl, and their food bowls are in their hutch right now. And there's like this big litter tray. It's really hard to show you because of the lighting, but I'll show you like in the daytime and other times as well. But yeah, so it's like a tub, and then there's in there's a tunnel that's folded up, a chew toy, a fleece, another pet mat, and then over there you really can't see, like really can't see, but there's like a hanging toy thing and a hedgehog, like a little hedgehog hanging basket, which is like a plant thing, but it works as a hay rack. So yeah, so I just shut that off for you. I'm sorry you can't really see. I've got it on low power mode because my phone's running out of charge. So that's why it's even darker for me. So I can't tell if you can see it very well, but on my phone you can't. But yeah, so this is it, and I hope you enjoyed it. And I will put a video of the indoor hutch in of Spots now as well. So.